Hello everyone, welcome to the course on genetics. In last video we have discussed about eye color in Drosophila, an example of inheritance of X-linked genes. Today also we will discuss same point, that is inheritance of X-linked genes, but we have selected the another example, that is color blindness in human. Let us start with this. So in human being, there are many X-linked traits are discovered till today by different types of geneticists. Some of them are color blindness, hemophilia, muscular dystrophy, ectodermal dysplasia, favism, and so many others. So today we will discuss about color blindness. So this is most important trait of X-linked genes. First of all, we should know what is color blindness. So color blindness, it is a trait, or it is a disease which is found in human being, in which a human or a man cannot distinguish between red and green color. So when we will say that when a person is color blind, he could not distinguish the colors red and green. So when we show him a red color, he will say it is a green, or when we show green color, he will see it is red in color. So he can't distinguish both colors. So why it happens? The dominant X-linked gene is responsible for that. If a person having no such dominant X-linked gene present, which is responsible for formation of the color sensitive cells or the cones in the retina of human eye. So there is a dominant X-linked gene which is responsible for formation of color sensitive cells or cones in the retina of human eye. Trichromatic theory of color vision says that there are three different types of cones, each with its characteristic pigment, which react most strongly with red, green, and violet light. So this theory, trichromatic theory of color vision, it says that there are three different types of cones and which will react differently with different types of rays like red, green, and violet. If any person he lacks such type of dominant X-linked gene, and in him a recessive X-linked allele is present, then in that person such type of formation of color sensitive cells and cones will not take place, and due to which that person cannot distinguish the colors red and green, and such person is known as color blind person. So a woman with such type of genotype, that is X small c, and the male with genotype XCY, he is known as color blind male. So these are the genotypes of female, and this is the genotype of color blind male. So this is the color blindness. Now we will see color blindness with two example, as we have discussed in eye color in Drosophila. Here also we will study two example, or we will study, or we will understand the concept of color blindness or X-linked inheritance by taking two example, two different crosses. So first cross we will made between color blind man and normal vision woman. So in first case we are selecting color blind man and a normal woman. So we have made a marriage between these two, and when color blind man marries with a normal vision woman, then they will produce normal vision male and female individuals in F1. The marriage between a F1 normal vision woman and normal vision male will produce two normal vision female वन नॉर्मल विजन मेल एंड वन कलर ब्लाइंड मेल इन एफ टू. सो इन दिस एग्जाम्पल वी हैव सेलेक्टेड कलर ब्लाइंड मैन दैट इज मेल एंड नॉर्मल विजन वुमेन. वेन दे गेट मैरिड दे विल प्रोड्यूस टू चिल्ड्रन टू ऑफ स्प्रिंग एंड बोथ आर नॉर्मल विजन एंड इन एफ वन नो एनी ऑफ स्प्रिंग इज हैविंग दिस पर्टिकुलर ट्रेड दैट इज कलर ब्लाइंडनेस. बट इन एफ टू दे विल प्रोड्यूस दिस ट्रेड. वी विल डिस्कस सच टाइप ऑफ दिस एग्जाम्पल विथ दिस डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन. हियर वी हैव सेलेक्टेड कलर ब्लाइंड मैन विच हैविंग द जीनोटाइप एक्स सी वाई एंड नॉर्मल विजन वुमेन विच हैविंग द जीनोटाइप एक्स एक्स. सो सी इज नॉर्मल सो दैट देर इज नो एनी सी प्रेजेंट. बट हियर ओनली as it is X linked inheritance, so C will be present only on X chromosome, not on Y. Gametes they will give rise to, it will form two types of gametes, XC and Y. Here both X are same, so it will form only one X and the offspring will be like this, F1 offspring. XC X it will give rise to XCX and YX that is XY. So here XX it will form normal daughter from these two parents and a normal son. But there is a difference in mother and daughter. So mother was totally homozygous and pure normal woman. But though this F1 female it is also normal for the trait, she have heterozygous X present because one of X have been come from the male and one X have been come from the normal woman. So here you can see this XC it is the trait which is having color blindness or the genes of color blindness. So in this generation this particular daughter it is said to be normal but she is carrier for the color blindness trait because she can pass on such type of trait to the next generation because it is present in their genotype, in her genotype, but she is not a color blind woman. So these two offspring will be formed in F1. Both, that is female as well as male, are normal vision, but female is carrier for color blindness. If we marry these two, XC and X, brothers and sister, if their marriage will be there, then what will happen? They will produce gametes like XC, X. And here XY, four types of gametes will be formed and they will produce four types of offspring. So this XC and this X it will produce normal daughter, then this XC and this Y it will produce color blind son, then this X and this X it will produce normal daughter, again this X and this Y it will produce normal son. So in this case you can see four types of offspring have been formed and one of them it is normal daughter but she is carrier for the trait. So she carries the genes for the color blindness because the color blindness gene it is present on only one X chromosome, so that lady or that daughter has no any symptoms of color blindness, but she has color blindness trait in her genotype and she can pass on that trait to the next generation. So though that lady is normal or that daughter is normal, she is carrier for the trait. Second offspring it is XCY, that is color blind son, because in males there is only one X present and if that X contains colorblind traits, then the son will be, or that male will be, definitely colorblind son. Now here, this particular daughter XX, she is completely normal. She is neither carrier or nor the colorblind. She is totally normal because she received one X normal X chromosome from her mother and one normal X chromosome from her father. Fourth offspring, that is XY, he is normal son because he received one X chromosome from his mother and one Y chromosome from his father. So this is very normal. So in this cross, four types of offsprings are formed in such type of phenotypes. Now we will see the conclusion from that. When a colorblind man XCY and normal vision woman XX is crossed in F1, they will produce a normal but carrier daughter XCX and normal vision son, that is XY. So we have discussed it. When these F1 offsprings are crossed, they will form F1 offsprings as follows. So first is normal but carrier daughter, another is colorblind son, third is normal daughter, and fourth is normal son. So we have seen in diagram. In females, it is very important to see, in females the two X chromosomes come from parent, one parent each. If only one X contains gene for colorblindness, then the female is with normal vision, but she is carrier for the trait and can pass on trait to the next generation. If such type of lady, she donates such type of XC chromosome to her offspring, and another XC will, if it is received by a male, then he will be definitely colorblind. Male contains only one X chromosome, and if that one contains gene for colorblindness, such male is colorblind as it is the X linked trait. So males are never the carrier for the trait. So only one C if present in males, then he will be colorblind, and if only one C is present in females, then C is carrier. As X male contains only one X, so he will never be a carrier for the trait. Directly he will be normal or colorblind. But in females you can see three possibilities in phenotype, that is normal female, carrier female, and third is colorblind female. It is clear from the experiment that if a man is colorblind and woman is normal, the percentage of colorblind offsprings in F1 and F2 generation is comparatively less. So if we select colorblind men and a normal woman, the percentage of colorblind offsprings in F1 and F2, it will be comparatively less. Now we will see the second case, that is marriage between normal vision man and colorblind woman. So here we have selected a normal visioned man. In first case we have selected the colorblind man, but here we have selected normal vision male, and here we have selected colorblind woman. So if a normal vision man marries a colorblind woman, F1 results in all colorblind son and all normal vision daughters. So in F1 they will form all colorblind men's or sons and all normal vision daughters. So if they will produce two offsprings, that is one male and one female, so the sons or males are always colorblind and females are normal. If F1 brothers and sisters married, they produce a colorblind homozygous daughter a normal vision heterozygous daughter, a normal vision hemizygous son, and a hemizygous color blind son. So let us see this example with diagram. So see, here we have selected normal man instead of color blind man, and color blind woman instead of normal woman. They will give, they have the genotypes. As human is, or man is normal, he has no any C present here, and he has normal genotype, that is XY. But woman, C is colorblind, and C contains 2C on both the X chromosomes. So gametes, they will give rise X, Y, and here only one gamete will be produced because both are common. So XC. So XCX, it will produce XCX and XCY. So here normal daughter have been produced. So in this generation, the daughter is normal one. She has no any symptoms of color blindness, but she has such type of trait in her genotype, and she can pass on that trait to the next generation. Here color blind son have been formed because there is only one X present and it contains C. So this male or this son, it is he is color blind. So in F1, one color blind and one normal offspring have been formed. The normal offspring, though present, it has such type of trait in his genotype, in her genotype. If these two get married, and they will produce four types of offsprings. So they will give rise to F1 gametes XC, X, then XC and Y. Now what will happen? See, this XC, it pairs with this XC, it will produce color blind daughter. So this daughter, first daughter, is completely color blind. Then this XC and Y, it is again giving rise to color blind son. Then this X and this XC, it will give rise to then normal daughter, but due to presence of one color blindness gene on one X chromosome, C is carrier for the trait. And fourth offspring will be XY. It is completely normal male because he received one of X chromosome from her, from his mother, and one Y chromosome from his father. So both are normal. So the son is normal. So in this case, four offspring have been formed. Two are colorblind, that is one male and one female are colorblind. One female and one male are normal. Though one female is normal, she has such type of trait in her genotype, and she will pass on that trait to the next generation, though she is normal in this generation. Now we will conclude from this. In this marriage, in the marriage of a normal vision man, that is XY, and a colorblind woman, XCX, F1 will produce a normal vision but carrier daughter, that is XCX, and a colorblind son, XCY. If both F1 brothers and sister marries with each other, they will produce four offsprings as follows. So see, four offsprings we have already discussed. First offspring, it is a colorblind daughter. Second offspring, it is colorblind son. Third offspring, it is a normal but carrier daughter. And fourth one is a normal son. So now we can conclude that the percentage of color blindness is comparatively higher here because both X chromosomes of female contains gene for color blindness. So if we compare this example with the first example, here you can see the percentage of color blindness in both males and females is higher than that of in first case, because if we select the color blind male and the normal woman, then the percentage of color blindness in F1 and F2 offspring, it was comparatively low. But if we select color blind woman and normal male, the percentage of color blind daughters and sons in F1 as well as F2 generation, it is comparatively high. So in such case, male receives color blind X chromosome from his mother and Y from his father. So percentage of color blindness in males is definitely increases. Also percentage of color blind and carrier females is also comparatively increases in such cases. So this is our conclusion from both the crosses. So these two examples will show that such type of inheritance can be seen in color blindness, that is X-linked inheritance. These are some references. If you like video, please like, comment, share, subscribe and press bell icon to get further notifications of new videos. Thank you.